Hello, my name is Sergei Gladkov. I live in Moscow in the Russian Federation. For 7 years, I was on a completely raw diet and met with many problems along the way. As a result, I had to create my own method of nutrition, and I am going to share it with you now. This new cooking method allows you to effectively nourish the body and at the same time avoid clogging it with waste and toxins. It combines the best properties of both raw and boiled food. I have called this method HOT ENZYMATION. Thanks to it, thousands of people in Russia were able to improve their health and strengthen their creative potential. The basics of this method are outlined in my ebook, Food for Kings, which is available on Amazon. You can also read about it on my website, foodforkings.com. From this video clip, you will learn how to quickly cook healthy foods using enzymes at elevated temperatures, how to significantly reduce the content of gluten, casein, and phytic acid in your diet by using this method. I'll explain one of the basic recipes of HOT ENZYMATION, a recipe for making incredible porridge from wheat sprouts. My message consists of two parts: a brief introduction to the method and a demonstration of the preparation of a unique dish. Most people try to find the best diet, balancing between raw and cooked foods. Over time, they are forced to exclude more and more types of food as they cause problems. For example, they avoid gluten or casein. As a rule, the weaker a person's health is, the wider these limitations. Sometimes there is nothing left that a person could safely eat. Fortunately, life is not located on the line between raw and boiled. The space of life is much wider. A little later, I will illustrate this with a triangle of diet alchemy. As a matter of fact, all living things prepare food with the help of enzymes in their stomachs. Pancreatic enzymes break down food and give its molecules such a form that is best assimilated in the body. If the food is too complicated to digest, the symbiont bacteria living in our intestines can help. But even their abilities are not enough when it comes to raw starch, gluten, or casein. To facilitate the digestion process, mankind has mainly used heat treatment. Boiled food is well absorbed, but it creates numerous impurities, as some parts of the food are denatured. So, heat treatment is a very crude way to decompose complex molecules of food. It resembles hammer blows on a crystal vase. People living in the face of information stress are at greatest risk. Their life force is spent on solving external problems, and their biological resource is not enough for reliable elimination of waste created by imperfect digestion. So, enzymes. This, in fact, was the dream of raw foodists, for food to digest itself. However, at the temperature of the human body, the enzymatic transformation of food requires at least 10 hours to complete. And therefore, raw food in the stomach doesn't have enough time to be digested by its own enzymes. The pancreas has to finish this work. However, many substances, for example oligosaccharides, can't be processed by the human enzyme system, even for a long time. Of course, food can be fermented in the traditional way using bacteria. This process is also quite lengthy. It takes about a week. And fermented foods are usually very acidic, which in itself is a risk factor. Now let's turn to the triangle of diet alchemy. Its lower left apex, at which you see a boiling pot, corresponds to boiled food, which gives us a lot of energy, but at the same time it strongly pollutes the body. The lower right apex corresponds to raw food, and you see here raw vegetables and fruits. Such food symbolizes purity, but it doesn't provide enough energy for life and creativity. We will try to combine energy and purity with the help of the sun of our consciousness, which shines in the center of the triangle, and then the miracle of the birth of a new, perfect structure of life, our renewed body, will occur. This is symbolized by a flame at the top of the triangle. We carry out this mysterious process with the help of enzymes, tireless workers of life. Strange as it might seem, the solution to the problem has long been known. All brewers are well aware of it. After all, they can very quickly and efficiently turn raw grain starches into simple sugars. But in order to use this method for cooking, it is necessary to overcome one very deeply rooted misconception that enzymes deactivate when heated about 42 Celsius or 107 Fahrenheit degrees. This statement is true only for enzymes of animal origin. While many plant and especially bacterial and fungal enzymes are maximally active at much higher temperatures, 60 to 70 Celsius or 140-160 Fahrenheit degrees. Some of them remain active up to the boiling point of water. I did a little internet search and the results are summarized in this table. Table of enzyme activity. You can see that many enzymes require a rather high temperature for their active work. This is actually hot enzymation. Therefore, the solution to the cooking problem is very simple. You need to heat the food to a temperature at which the enzyme activity is maximum. This allows 10 times acceleration of the enzymatic conversion. And we get the opportunity to cook the perfect food in an ordinary kitchen. It's important to understand that although we warm the food a little, this is not a heat treatment. This is an optimized enzymatic process in which the selectivity and specificity of the enzymes are maintained. This is where this method differs from traditional slow cooking. Now we are turning from the theory to practice. To implement this wonderful cooking method, we need a powerful blender to grind food and evenly distribute its enzymes, and a programmable multi-cooker to heat food to a strictly defined temperature. For our demonstration experiments, we will take wheat sprouts, which are rather difficult to digest. They contain a lot of raw starches, complex proteins, including gluten, and coarse fiber, which can endure the intestines. Raw sprouts are a touchstone for any culinary system. Let's make sure that HOT ENZYMATION is able to turn this hardly edible substrate into a tasty, aromatic, and well-digestible porridge that doesn't burden the body's elimination system. Look, you need to take the sprouts like these ones. The length of the sprouts should be approximately 2 to 3 millimeters. This will take from 24 to 36 hours, depending on the ambient temperature. It is easiest to germinate in a conventional pan with the lid displaced a little bit for better ventilation. At night, we soak the grain, and during the day it sprouts. To green the seedlings, you should use a blender with a power of at least 1.5 kilowatts. And if you work with small portions, then the so-called extractors are more convenient. I use a NutriBullet. Now put the sprouts into a blender, pour in some water and blend. Do not put too much water. The dough should be dense enough. So whisk, gradually adding water. You can try the dough in order to understand well where we are starting. I don't think you would like its taste. Then we should place the finished dough in the multi-cooker bowl. Ideally, if dough is just thick and viscous like cream and not liquid. Now you need to program the multi-cooker. One should set the temperature at which the beta amylase enzyme has the highest productivity. Then it will be able to turn almost all raw starch into maltose, a type of a simple sugar, in about 1 hour. This magic temperature is 65 Celsius or 149 Fahrenheit degrees. But if you do not want the porridge to be too sweet, then you have to set a different magic temperature, 72 Celsius or 162 Fahrenheit degrees. It best matches the alpha amylase enzyme, which converts starch into dextrins, and as a result, porridge will acquire the taste of well-cooked pasta. You can choose the duration of these two cooking modes to your taste. I prefer that each stage lasts 30 minutes. This is a real diet alchemy. By just slightly changing the multi-cooker mode of operation, we get dishes with completely different tastes. Therefore, summarizing all the above, we can describe our alchemical process using the formula that you see on the screen. Here, the numbers in parentheses are the duration of the stage in minutes. Please note, the dough should lie on the bottom of the bowl with a thin layer, not more than 1.5 or 2 centimeters maximum. Otherwise, it will not warm up properly. If your multi-cooker allows you to program only one cooking step, then this doesn't matter. In this case, you will have to restart it once more. Of course, in our raw dough, there are many other nutrients, and there are also corresponding enzymes present that can transform and simplify these substances. So, if we smoothly raise the cooking temperature, lingering at the points corresponding to optimum performance of the main enzymes, we will enable each of the food enzymes to do their job properly. For example, the phytase enzyme will decompose phytic acid. So, start the multi-cooker and wait 60 minutes. Now is the time to harvest our efforts. Let's open the lid and see what happened. The surface of the dough has noticeably darkened and acquired the color of coffee with milk. So, porridge smells promising. I would say that it has the smell of freshly baked cookies. Let me remind that we have made absolutely no add-ons to our dough. Only gray raw dough has been placed in the multi-cooker. Now let's try it. Fantastic taste. The porridge tastes like cookies soaked in milk. In addition, new very subtle aromas have appeared that evoke childhood memories. After cooling a little, add 1 tablespoon of flaxseed oil to the porridge. You can also add some salt, and that's it. Nothing more is needed. Why look for happiness if it already lies on your plate? Some viewers will probably ask, what about gluten? I am glad to answer that there is practically no gluten in this dish. All of it has been eaten, that is converted into peptides by proteases of sprouts. You can make sure that I am not exaggerating, only when you repeat this experiment and try yourself. Of course, there is always a chance of making an error, because the sprouted grain can be very different, and you need to be diligent and even intuitive in order to find the right cooking mode. To help you in this quest, I have written an ebook. It is called Food for Kings. It can be downloaded on Amazon. In the near future, I plan to release several more books on this topic. In them, I will tell you how to use the HOT ENZYMATION method for cooking legumes, mushrooms, nuts, vegetables, dairy products, and even to accelerate the ripening of fruits. These books will be published under the general serial name HOT ENZYME Nutrition. You can also visit my website foodforkings.com, where I give more detailed explanations. You can download some recipes and leave your review. I wish you good health and bon appetit!